All right, so we've talked a lot about coming up with a tripwire and different tripwire types and different ideas. And still, at this point, you know, when I talk to a lot of folks, I say, yeah, I still just have a very difficult time, you know, coming up with mine. And in particular, you know, how can I come up with a little victory? So I want to give you a scenario that you can deploy to brainstorm your own little victory for your market. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to picture in your mind your customer. Right? Who are they? And then what I also want you to picture in your mind is an old friend of yours from college or university, or if you didn't go to college, maybe from high school, someone that you knew when you were younger, but you've kind of fallen apart. It's not like you had a falling out or anything like that. You just, life happened. You went one way, they went another. I want you to picture this person in your mind. Now I want you to collapse the two. Okay? I want you to picture that this person that you remember from your history that you haven't talked to in forever, but that if you saw them or if they called you one day, you'd be really excited to hear from them, okay? I want you to picture that this person is your ideal customer. They are your ideal client. Now, that may require a, you know, momentary sex change or maybe thinking of a different person if the, you know, genders didn't quite match up. So if you need to do that, then great, do that. Or maybe pretend that it's your friend and they're calling about a spouse that is of the appropriate gender, okay? But I want you to picture that friend. I want you to think about them, okay? I want you to think about them and think that they are dealing with the exact same problem and the exact same issue that your ideal customer is dealing with. Okay? You got that scenario locked in your brain? Good. Now what I want you to do is I want you to imagine yourself sitting on your couch. Okay? It's late at night. You're unwinding after a long day. You're enjoying your beverage of choice and you're watching something on TV or maybe you're reading a book. You're doing whatever you do to unwind during the evening. Okay? Put yourself in that setting. I know this is a little bit creepy, but put yourself in that setting. Okay? Put yourself there. Now, so you're sitting there doing whatever you do to unwind at the end of the night, and your phone rings. And you look down at your phone, and you don't recognize the number, but something tells you that you should answer, and so you do. So you click the phone, and you pull it to your ear, and you immediately hear, you say, hello? And you hear, hey, Bob, and whatever your name is. And you say, hey, yeah, who is this? And then you find out that it's your old friend that you haven't talked to in years and years and years. And you're excited, like, wow. How's everything? You know, this is great. It's so good to hear from you. You know, how are things going? Okay? You know, how are things going? Now, think about your customer. How are things going for them? Are they generally happy? Are they generally sad? Are they frustrated? And then I want you to imagine their first word. Let's go back to the before and after grid. The first word that they say is the first word that you wrote down in the before and the feel section. Okay, so in the feel and the before, imagine that first word is the first word that you hear. Okay? I gotta be honest, I'm a little frustrated. You know, I'm upset, I'm unhappy. Yeah, things are pretty good, right? Whatever it is, what is that thing that they would say? And now just imagine the dialogue going something like this. They say things are pretty good, things are whatever. So if I'm the, going back to the before and after, if I'm the, you know, frustrated, underappreciated mom, then I'd say, you know, things are okay, I guess. You know, I'm a little bit, you know, I'm just a little bit frustrated. You know, we just had a new baby, we got this infant. And, you know, bath time is just terrible. And, you know, I got to tell you that, you know, the reason that I'm calling is because I was out there, you know, searching on, you know, Google, and I'm looking around for a solution. And lo and behold, you know, I see your face. Okay. Or let's think about the weight loss thing, right? So I'm gonna think about my friend Drew, who really is the face of this fitness company, right? Maybe an old friend of his from college, a lady calls him up saying, you know, I'm just, you know, my best friend's getting married. I'm going to be in the wedding and I need to lose weight and I need to do it quickly, right? So imagine this dialogue, right? They're calling you because they found you. They were doing some searching because they have the problem that your customer had. They were doing some searching and they came across you and your brand. They found you and now they're calling you asking for help. You've got an old friend calling you asking for help because you're an expert at this. Now, if you're an agency or a marketing professional or a consultant, you might want to run through this scenario with the owner of the company or with an executive at the company. So I want you to imagine now, what would you say to that person? What would you say to that person to make them feel better? You're over the phone, right? You can't solve all their world's problems. I mean, so let's say this lady calls my friend Drew, you know, my my friend's getting married in a week, and I don't fit into my dress, and I'm going to be so embarrassed. I mean, you know, it's humiliating even calling you. Can you help me? Now, what a lot of people would do is they'd say, well, you know, because I'll ask them, like, what would you say to somebody to make them feel better? And they'll say, well, you know, I'd make sure that they knew that, well, it took some time to put the weight on. It's going to take some time to put the weight off, blah, 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 blah. And they'd say a lot of stupid crap that you wouldn't actually ever say if you actually had a friend calling you upset, asking for help. You would say something to make them feel better. What would you say in that moment to make them feel better? You would acknowledge that you can't solve all the world's problems, right? That's what the core offer is about. But what would you say to make them feel better? What would you say to move them down that continuum of belief? If you walk through the scenario and really think it through, really live it, really imagine the details. Where are you sitting? What are you drinking? What are you watching? Who's calling, right? If you can put yourself in that state, I promise, if you go through this, you're gonna get pretty creative pretty quickly. So think about scenario, the phone call from the old college friend. Who's calling you? What are they saying? How do they feel? And what are you going to say in that moment to make them feel better about it? Take 10 minutes, see what you can come up with and write it down. And I'll see you in the next one.